Anderson Cooper 360, weeknights at 8 and 10 on CNN.
Christopher Dorner, the target of this massive manhunt tonight, has made his intentions clear. Police say he's vowed to hunt down and kill cops he once worked with and to target their families as well. In a rambling manifesto that he allegedly wrote, he brags about his shooting skills. Here's what he says. Hopefully you analysts have done your homework. You're aware that I have always been the top shot, highest score, and expert in rifle qualifications in every unit I've been in. I will utilize every bit of small arms training, demolition, ordnance, and survival training I've been given. Certainly chilling words. As we said, Dorner, a former cop who served in the U.S. Navy Reserve, is a trained sniper. It's what makes this manhunt both urgent and particularly dangerous. Chris Lawrence joins me now. Chris, in this manifesto, he says he's always been the top shot, as I just read. Do his military records back that up?
Military-wise, Anderson, he's good, but he's exaggerating a little bit. The U.S. Navy has three levels of proficiency above the baseline. Those are marksman, sharpshooter, and then expert at the highest level. He qualified as a marksman with the rifle, but he did qualify as an expert, the highest level, with a 9mm pistol. He also received some training on weak side shooting. Even some very good shooters have a hard time going from the right hand to the left hand. He would have been trained in shooting from his weak side, and where that can come into play is if you're shooting from a concealed position, if you can shoot from your weak side, you might not have to expose as much of your body. You'd be a smaller target and still be able to return fire.
This guy also promises to use specific warfare tactics and survival training. He was never in special ops, which would obviously have more specific training in this kind of thing.
No special operations training, but he did serve in a riverine unit, sort of the old brown water Navy, doing a lot of security operations, securing oil platforms. So he has had more firearms and combat arms training than, say, a typical sailor serving on board an aircraft carrier.